Let us now discuss how we can protect our crops from pests and diseases with just a little precaution and a very little effort.
Medicinal Magic Tonic. The requirements for making this biopesticide are some latex-containing leaves, odor leaves and sour leaves, some turmeric powder, garlic, cow dung and cow urine. Let us chop the leaves into small pieces. The smaller, the better. Next, we put all the items collected into a pitcher and stir it well with cow dung and cow urine. After everything is mixed well, we have to put some crushed garlic into it and stir it again. Let us seal the pitcher mouth with a piece of polythene and keep it under shade for 15 days. When mixed with water and applied in the field, this green pesticide protects the crop from 50 different diseases. Instead of chemical fertilizers, we use biofertilizers. This will make the plants healthy and the crop bountiful. There will be no pest or disease attack either. Indigenous Gamaxin. The items required to make it are some tobacco leaves, kerosene, country lime, sulfur, chalk powder and some ash. The tobacco leaves have to be crushed and powdered first. Then some country lime, sulfur, kerosene, manure powder and ash have to be added to it and stirred well. After it is completely mixed, we can apply it in the fields to protect our crops from termites and ants. We will now prepare organic pesticides to protect our vegetable crops from leaf curd disease. The items needed for this are some sun-dried rice gruel, some turmeric powder, chili powder and water. A glass each of gruel and water has to be mixed with 5 spoonfuls each of turmeric powder and chili powder and stirred well. After it is fully mixed, it can be applied in the field before sunrise to protect the crop from leaf curd disease. This mixture can be used for 7 days. We can also chop agal leaves, take out its juice, mix it with water and apply it in the paddy fields before sunrise to protect the crops from blast disease. Kunupa water. The intestine of fish and some molasses are the two major items necessary to make kunupa water. The two are to be put in a pitcher and stirred well. The mouth of the pitcher is then sealed with a piece of polythene. In 10 days, the biopesticide is ready to be applied in the fields in the ratio of 5 mg of pesticide mixed in 25 liters of water. It protects the crop from a host of diseases. Raw garlic is crushed and mixed with kerosene and kept for 7 days in a sealed condition. After 7 days, the garlic pieces are separated from this solution and the rest is applied in the fields to protect the crops from necrosis disease. Epilakna disease. An equal amount of agal and holy basil have to be crushed and then mixed with a liter of milk before being put in a pitcher. The mouth of the pitcher has to be sealed with a piece of cloth. After 12 hours, 50 milliliters of this solution mixed in 10 liters of water can be sprayed in the field shortly after sunrise or before sunset to protect it from the disease. 100 grams of tobacco leaves along with 100 grams of chili powder has to be boiled in an earthen pitcher. When the water is boiled properly, 2 liters more of water has to be added to it. The use of this solution in the field protects the brinjal crops from the fruit borer disease. Trap cropping. The planting of marigold and holy basil in the vegetable and fruit fields attracts the insects towards them and spares the main crop. Bird perching. Fixing some stumps in the field encourages birds to perch on it. Not only do they eat up various insects, but also defecate in the field, which increases the fertility of the soil. Biotrapping. Placing biotrapping instruments in the field attracts insects into them and traps them inside. The process does away with the need for pesticides for these insects. Magic lamp. We can also prepare a light trap and place a pitcher containing some molasses or kerosene water. Insects are drawn to it either due to the light or the smell of the molasses water and get trapped inside.
High yield varieties of seeds require huge amount of water. That is why the government had to implement a series of irrigation projects. This led to the destruction of vast stretches of forests and large-scale displacement. The farmer needed high-quality water pumps. Such was the irrigation that some lands had more water than needed, while others went completely dry. Waterlogging for long periods increased the saline content in water and spelt disaster for the soil.
Nearly 4 million hectares of upland has either been salinized or waterlogged this way. In other words, that much of land is no more cultivable.
Too many civilizations have perished because of profusion of water. The best way to increase production is to use less water and increase the moisture retention capacity of the soil instead.
Mulching. Covering the soil at the base of the plant with straw, hay, leaves, stems and brick pieces is called mulching. It prevents sun rays from falling directly on the soil and thus protects it from hardening. It also enhances the water retention capacity of the soil. The topsoil does not get washed away easily. After decomposition, the covering mingles with the soil and strengthens it. Besides, it also does not allow the growth of wild grass. When a circular pit is dug at some distance from the plant, filled with cow dung water, fresh and dry leaves and stems, and then covered with soil, it is called inside mulching. When the mix is left open, it is called outside mulching. Organic farming requires less water on the one hand and increases the water retention capacity of the soil on the other. That is why excess water has to be regularly drained out. There is no water in the field at all. Do you think the crop will survive? Yes, it will. Since chemical fertilizers have not been used, it would not hot up easily. The healthy leaves will ensure a good crop. Planting of small plants at the base of large trees leads to an increase in the yield. Pitcher garden. A pitcher is perforated at 2 to 4 places and then buried in the ground. Plants are sown around the pitcher and the pitcher regularly filled with water. The water seeps through these perforations and goes into the plants. If the number of plants is large, we can use a long pipe, so-called pitcher irrigation, to irrigate them.
A major requirement in the use of high-yield seeds is the use of improved agriculture implements. But tilling the soil with the tractors or power tillers kills the earthworms and the other helpful microorganisms which play an important role in increasing soil fertility.
The use of tractors hardens the soil. More instruments are needed to make it soft again. By deep plowing, the bacteria on top of the soil go inside and those deep in the soil come to the surface. The bacteria on the top, which need plenty of air, die once they go inside. The aerobic bacteria, which can make do with very little oxygen, too die once they come up. The net result is a drastic reduction in the number of beneficial bacteria in the soil. These microorganisms are the real strength of the soil.
But use of the indigenous plough poses no such danger. The use of cow dung provides the much needed feed for the earthworms and other friendly organisms, thus helping in the proliferation of increase of soil fertility. Several organizations are now playing a pioneering role in persuading farmers to achieve modern agriculture and popularizing our indigenous system of agriculture.
The efforts of the people are limited. Till the government encourages it, it can never become a revolution or benefit all. Organic farming must receive the topmost priority in the agriculture policy that the government is formulating. Sustained efforts are needed to convince the people to shun chemical agriculture from organic farming.
A series of books, periodicals and posters are now being published and meetings held to generate awareness on the issue. The net result of these efforts has been new awakening among the people.
What have you tied here? 1 kilogram each of neem leaves, agar leaves and custard apple leaves. Why? To protect the crop from diseases. How will it protect the crop against disease? The aroma of these leaves will spread over the entire land and protect the crop. Instead of chemical fertilizers, we use pitcher manure, leaves and stems collected from the forest and cow dung in our field. We observe that use of iron tiller killed the earthworm in the field. We did not get a good crop. We find the wooden plough much better. I plant tomato in 60 decimals of land. I used to get tomato worth no more than Rs 7,000 to 8,000 earlier. But after resorting to organic farming, the same land now fetches me an income of not less than Rs 16,000.
Many farmers have now realized the benefits of organic farming. They have come to know that it will help to produce safe, poison-free food. The environment will come alive once again. Diseases will become the thing of the past. This awakening among the farmers is a ray of hope for the future generations.
आशा भाई भौणी जीवा विषमुक्ति गा आमे करीबा।